Hi everyone and welcome to a brand new quick tip by JANUS Engineering. Recently, or better said a few months ago, we've created a video to show you how to deburr cross holes with the help of a lolipop cutter within Siemens NX. Well, due to a new version of Siemens NX, we are now having more capabilities in doing so. But for showing this, let me first return to my NX session. And here we are again. So, with the very new release of the Siemens NX that we are having in front of us now, we can first of all see the parts geometry that we are having. As you see, there's one hole and a second hole, and both of them are crossing each other, and that edge in here needs a deburring on it. So what do I do first? First of all, I'm creating a spherical mill, or better said, lollipop mill. It looks like so in my case. And with the very new operation that I have in mind for us, we can start to deburr this exact geometry. For this, let's go to the mill contour type. And within the mill contour type, there's a new operation appearing that says multi-axis deburring. Select it, pay attention that the spherical mill is also selected, and hit the OK icon. There we go. So in this dialog, what is necessary to be set? First of all, this checkmark that says automatic edges needs to be deselected because I want to specify the edge that I want to deburr. And in my case, it's going to be this guy in here. Click on OK. And down here, we also see the deburring control applied with a width, and the width shall be 0.5 millimeters. So actually, that's it for me now. I will just simply generate a toolpath. And we see a toolpath appearing on my part. When I pick the tool and put it on its place, we see that the edge is being deburred now. Not just for deburring operations like so, this operation is quite useful, but it's also useful if I want to deburr the exact, the very same edge, but not from the left side, but from above. How do I do that? First of all, I copied the operation. The edge is still specified. And the only thing for me to do now is I want to tilt the axis. Instead of the ZM axis, I'm gonna specify the vector by clicking on that face. There we go. Generate a toolpath. And we see now the toolpath appearing within the part. So when I put the tool on its place, we see how the tool is now deburring the very same edge, but from another angle. So that's actually it for now for today. Thank you for your attention. And we always appreciate a new subscription from you guys. And also, of course, the like button. And of course, all your comments below if you do have any questions to ask. All right then, see you next time. Bye bye.